Fun facts about African wild dogs. African wild dogs are some of the favorite animals to see on safari. There's nothing quite like coming across a large pack of these graceful animals in the bush.
Their beautiful spotty coats are black, brown, white, and yellow, and their social nature makes them a joy to watch. Here's some amazing facts about Africa's painted wolf.
African wild dogs are known by many different names. The scientific name of the African wild dog is Lycaon pictus, a Latin term meaning painted wolf. This is the most common nickname for the African wild dog, but they are known by many other monikers including Cape hunting dog, painted dog, African hunting dog, painted hunting dog, and ornate wolf. African wild dogs are neither wolves nor dogs, despite the common English names. Size: weigh between 40 to 80 pounds, 18 to 36 kilograms. Females are generally 3 to 7% smaller than males. The species stands 24 to 30 inch in shoulder height, measures 28 to 44 inch in head and body length. Their tail is relatively large and always tipped with white. They are long-legged and slender with a broad skull. An African wild dog's spotted coat is unique. Similar to other gray African animals with distinct coat patterns, no two wild dogs have the same spotted patterns. These are unique to individual wild dogs and help members within the pack distinguish between one another. The beautiful colors of their coat, black, brown, yellow, and white, also helps wild dogs blend into their natural habitat of grassland, savanna, and woodland. African wild dogs are incredibly social. Wild dogs live in packs ranging in size from 6 to 30 members, making their packs one of the largest of the wild canines. Since wild dogs live in such close proximity with each other, they have evolved to be incredibly social. There is a hierarchy within a pack led by a dominant breeding pair, and struggle is generally limited within the pack once this hierarchy has been established. Wild dogs communicate with one another through touch, tail wags, and a variety of vocalizations that include a short bark, which can signify alarm, a howl, which rallies the wild dogs together, and a bell-like sound, which can be heard over long distances. A wild dog's vocalizations go well beyond that of a domestic dog. They greet each other with twittering and whining sounds, and when one dog has lost the group, it will make an owl-like howl, calling to find a pack. African wild dogs are highly intelligent. Unlike many other pack hunting animals, wild dogs of a single pack rarely intimidate or fight one another for position. Instead, they exhibit behaviors that support the health of the pack over individual members. For example, younger members of the pack who conduct hunts will bring back food for the older members. Similarly, young cubs are raised by all members of the pack, including both male and female members. African wild dogs are wanderers. Wild dog packs roam large areas and rarely stay in a single place for long. As a result, wild dogs require large territories to thrive. Wild dogs in Tanzania's Serengeti, for example, have been known to roam an area over 900 square miles. African wild dogs have unique physical features. Unlike their domestic counterparts, wild dogs only have 4 toes per 4 feet. In addition, a wild dog's large, round ears allow them to keep track of pack members over long distances through audio signals. African wild dogs have large litters. With litter of 2 to 20 pups, wild dogs have some of the largest litters of wild canines. Usually more than twice as many males are born as females, and in a behavior unique to wild dogs, when the pups reach maturity, the females leave the pack to look for mates while the males stay in their natal pack. African wild dogs are crepuscular. African wild dogs are most active during twilight, the period immediately before dawn and after dusk, making them crepuscular. twilight is a key time for wild dogs because their prey is most active during this period, and the cover of night gives wild dogs a hunting and camouflage advantage, making them more difficult to be detected by both predators and prey. African wild dogs are expert hunters. Before initiating a hunt, African wild dogs conduct a playful ceremony in which they circle one another, touching and vocalizing to get themselves excited about the coming hunt. Wild dogs are built for endurance. They can maintain speeds of up to 35 miles per hour over a range of 3 miles, which allows them to outlast their prey. This stamina combined with smart hunting tactics, where some members lead the hunt close to prey while others tactically circle the prey, results is an extremely high hunting success rate. Some experts predict that wild dogs are successful in 80% of their hunting attempts. By comparison, the hunting rate of polar bears is only 2%. Threats to African wild dogs. The primary threats to African wild dogs are hunting and habitat loss, as well as competition from larger carnivores such as lions and spotted hyenas. African wild dogs are also often persecuted by farmers wanting to protect livestock, and can even be prone to picking up diseases from domestic animals. African wild dogs' diet and prey. The African wild dogs is a carnivorous and opportunistic predator, hunting larger animals on the African plains in their big group. African wild dogs primarily prey on large mammals such as warthogs and numerous species of antelope, supplementing their diet with rodents, lizards, birds, and insects. They are even known to hunt much larger herbivores that have been made vulnerable through sickness or injury, such as wildebeest. Although the African wild dog's prey is often much faster, the chase can last for miles, and it is this dog's stamina and perseverance that makes them so successful, along with the ability to maintain their speed. Hunting as a pack also means that the African wild dogs can easily corner their prey. Unlike many other carnivores, African wild dogs kill their prey by starting to bite it when it is still alive. Although this may sound cruel, the animal actually dies more quickly and less painfully than if it was killed in the general way. Prey is chased by the pack and smaller animals are pulled down. Larger prey may keep running while the dogs continue to bite and tear at it. In both cases, prey dies quickly, usually from shock or loss of blood. The long, large intestine of the African wild dog means that they have a very efficient system for absorbing as much moisture from their food as possible. This gives these canines an advantage in such arid climates, as they do not need to find such a regular supply of water. African wild dogs are therefore able to go for long periods of time without needing to drink. Habitat. The African wild dog is mostly found in savanna and arid zones, generally avoiding forested areas. This preference is likely linked to the animal's hunting habits, which require open areas that do not obstruct vision or impede pursuit. Nevertheless, it will travel through scrub, woodland, and mountain areas in pursuit of prey. The African wild dog has very strong social bonds, stronger than those of sympatric lions and spotted hyenas. Thus, solitary living and hunting are extremely rare in the species. The fur of the African wild dog differs significantly from that of other canids, consisting entirely of stiff bristle hairs with no underfur. Distribution. African wild dogs once ranged across much of sub-Saharan Africa, being absent only in the driest desert regions and lowland forests. Wild dogs do not have big powerful jaws like cats, so they cannot bring down large animals alone. Hunting in a pack requires cooperation among pack members. This enables wild dogs to bring down animals 5 times their size. The large, round ears of the African wild dog have 2 functions. They have excellent hearing for hunting prey, and their large ears help cool the dog off in the hot African climate. Only the dominant male and female in a pack cock a hind leg when urinating. Subordinate animals in a pack urinate with all four legs on the ground. At the zoo, a commercial meat product with high protein dog chow. The food is fortified with vitamins and minerals, which include smoked pig ears and bones. How long do African wild dogs live for? On average, African wild dogs live for 7 years. In captivity, they can live up to 13 years. Are African hunting dogs affected by climate change? Research from ZSL's Institute of Zoology illustrates that wild dog breeding pairs raise fewer pups at ever-increasing climatic temperatures. That's all I want to say in this video. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.